Welcome to this edition of CBN News Sunday. I'm Charlene Aaron. This week, the fight for life in America when it comes to abortion, from hearings on defunding Planned Parenthood in Congress to grassroots efforts to expose the nation's largest abortion provider. But first, many abortion opponents cheered the recent takedown of House Speaker John Boehner, saying he didn't really fight for the pro-life cause. But as CBN's Paul Strand reports, not everyone agrees.
North Carolina's Robert Pittenger is an ardent pro-life supporter in the halls of Congress.
One of Congressman Pittenger's main crusades here in Washington is to stop government from paying for abortion, something that's specifically disallowed under the Hyde Amendment.
It gets encroached upon continually, and we have to be vigilant and on guard to make sure that we don't allow that to happen.
He took to the House floor recently to argue states should be free to give Medicaid funds to health care providers who won't do abortions. Unlike the money that goes to Planned Parenthood, the biggest abortion provider in the country.
Like in North Carolina, we have 634 clinics for women. Then there's about 9 clinics that are Planned Parenthood. And of course, those are abortion providers. So we could take that same money and put it in our own clinics for women.
Ironically, it's been the pro-life cause and the move to stop taxpayer money from going to Planned Parenthood that put the pro-life Speaker of the House into a position where he felt he had to resign.
Conservatives out to defund Planned Parenthood felt that John Boehner wasn't really in the fight enough with them. But Congressman Pittenger, a good friend of Boehner's, says that his fellow conservatives don't really understand just how conservative and just how pro-life Boehner really is.
John Boehner did a remarkable job, frankly, in our country. In fact, the pro-life movement says that he's been the strongest pro-life Speaker of the House that we've had in modern history. So I commend him for that.
And he says Boehner certainly isn't to blame for this being labeled the do-nothing Congress.
The last term, we passed 387 bills, and they stayed on the desk of Harry Reid in the Senate. This year, we have already passed more legislation, conservative legislation, than any other time but 1 year in the last 40 years.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Capitol Hill.
Well, Planned Parenthood has had a startling agenda from its inception, started by a woman whose goal in part was controlling the black population through abortion and sterilization. Here's a look at what abortion and abortion providers have done to black minorities.
Abortion is black genocide. What happens to a mind of a person and the moral fabric of a nation that can accept the aborting of a child without a pang of conscience?
In many black communities, for every child actually born, 3 others are aborted, more than double the rate among whites. Dr. Clennard Childress, founder of blackgenocide.org, says the consequences of those figures will eventually end up destroying a whole race of Americans.
African Americans here in this country are the only ethnic group in any place on the globe that's not replacing themselves. This is genocide.
Some say abortion is the number one killer in the black community, leading more and more African American churches to speak out and take a stand for life. Bishop Daniel Robertson of Richmond's Mount Gilead Baptist Church says black pastors have a responsibility to their communities to do more.
We really need to just, you know, make a statement to the community that we believe the Bible, thou shalt not kill.
But Robertson's church does more than just preach against abortion. For one, they encourage their members to consider adopting these unplanned children.
We go to the abortion clinics and ask people. There are other alternatives. We try to educate people and let them know you don't have to do this. And so we do have that ongoing ministry. And then because our doors are open and we preach the message of Jesus Christ, we do try to give people hope.
In his book, No Shepherd's Cry, Childress says the black church can no longer be silent on the issue.
If there's a devouring force that is decimating my community, as a shepherd, I must respond with the truth and deliver the lamb with its young, from the wolf and the devourer. And the devourer is the abortion industry.
Dr. Childress points out this should come as no surprise, considering that black Americans were long ago targets of the abortion industry. In the early 20th century, Margaret Sanger founded Planned Parenthood, an organization that later became the nation's largest abortion provider. Sanger encouraged abortion and sterilization to limit the size of black families. Childress says she also used the unaware black minister to further her agenda.
Margaret Sanger, a devout racist, a eugenics, and the author of the Negro Project, knew that the colored minister was going to be pivotal in getting her program across.
Because of that, both Robertson and Childress believe black clergy must take the lead in fighting against abortion.
The colored minister, the Negro minister, the African-American minister is pivotal right now in addressing the abortion issue because we have been silent due to political ties and due to some misinformation.
But Robertson says the issue isn't just with the black church, but with the faith community as a whole.
There are a lot of pastors, whether they're black or white, they're just comfortable. They don't want to stir up anything. You can't just stay behind the stained glass windows of your sanctuary, but you really do have to reach out into the community and make a difference.
Coming up, Planned Parenthood myths laid to rest by one of its own as she testifies before Congress. Planned Parenthood President Cecile Richards' own testimony before Congress this week may be the very thing that clears up a few myths about the agency believed as fact. You can go to our website to see the story analysis, Five Planned Parenthood Myths Debunked by Leaders' Testimony. I also spoke with Concerned Women for America's Janae Straw-Key about the testimony and those myths. Janae, first of all, give me your observations on the Planned Parenthood funding hearings this week on Capitol Hill.
Yeah, definitely. You know, I thought it was very, very interesting. The point of the hearing was to get to the bottom of where our tax dollars are going, the money that is given to Planned Parenthood each year. And there were some really great and necessary questions asked to Ms. Richards. Representative Loomis at one point questioned her on the 3% abortion and asked, why is 86% of your revenue coming from abortions, if that statistic is true? There is a whole list. In fact, I want to read a couple quotes here that I found very important, and I don't want to get them wrong. Mulvaney said, if we took $60 million away, you could still perform every single service that you gave last year. And wow. It was things like that that make it so evident that Planned Parenthood doesn't need our tax dollars.
Amazing, amazing. And why do you think the mainstream media is not reporting the facts from the hearing or on Planned Parenthood?
You know, a lot of the mainstream media is very liberal. We all have biases. I have a bias. And the difference is that they have a platform. And I think a lot of them don't want the truth to get out there. I've even spoken with many people who just simply haven't watched the videos. They don't know what's going on with Planned Parenthood. And I think by not watching the videos, it's easier to deny the truth. It's easier to not acknowledge it. And I think that's exactly what the mainstream media is doing. They're simply trying to deny the truth by not sharing it.
Indeed. And what are the top three myths about Planned Parenthood that your organization and other pro-life groups would like to see debunked?
Yeah, you know, the first myth that comes to mind is mammograms. This has been talked about so much within the pro-life circle that you would think this is well known now or it's common knowledge, but then you have Miss Tennessee on the stage of Miss America saying that they do perform a mammogram. You've got them talking about it on The View saying that they do perform mammograms. And in the hearing, Miss Richards said herself, they in fact do not perform mammograms and they're not licensed to. In fact, if any Planned Parenthoods were performing mammograms, they would be acting illegally. The other thing that I think of is their 3% of abortion statistic. This has been debunked, and there are videos out there that show how they get that statistic. Really, for Planned Parenthood, it's a shell game. The way that they twist their numbers to make their percentages look the way that they want them to do. And really, the majority of what Planned Parenthood does is abortion, and that 3% is extremely misleading. The last thing that I think of is that many people in support of Planned Parenthood have said that without federal funding for Planned Parenthood, women do not have healthcare options. And this is also a myth. This is simply not true.
Indeed. Well, tell us about the alternatives that women have besides Planned Parenthood for health services, and do all of these organizations get funding like Planned Parenthood?
Yeah, so as I just mentioned, it's not true that women don't have options. And just Tuesday was the launch of a new website, which Concerned Women for America is proudly sponsoring. It's called getyourcare.org. And this is an interactive website to show women the options that they do have. There are over 1,300 federally qualified health clinics that offer even more comprehensive care to women than Planned Parenthood. And again, in the hearing on Tuesday, Ms. Richards also admitted this, that these clinics actually outnumber Planned Parenthood 20 to 1. And on average, they are within 5 miles of a Planned Parenthood. So there are many, many options out there for women, and we want to make sure that they know about them. So you can go to getyourcare.org and locate a number of clinics that are close to you. And these are low-cost, high-quality care clinics that are receiving federal funds. And what we would like to see is our tax dollars taken and given to clinics that are helping women rather than Planned Parenthood, who is untrustworthy. And they've continued to prove that to us. Abortion is their number one priority, and abortion is not health care.
Absolutely amazing. And that website, again, is getyourcare.org. Janae Strawkey, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Up next, mainstream media shutdown as a member of a pro-family, pro-life organization joins a panel discussing Planned Parenthood. Recently, Allison Howard of Alliance Defending Freedom was a panel guest on Headline News' Dr. Drew program discussing Planned Parenthood. Take a look at what happened when she brought up the fact of Planned Parenthood not reporting assault cases as the law requires.
I'm talking about the young girls that were taken to Planned Parenthood by their perpetrators and who wish Planned Parenthood shouted about their abuse, but instead, as we've seen in recent reports, covered up that sexual abuse. And I'm talking about taxpayers shouting about the fact that Planned Parenthood has been caught in serious...
If somebody was duplicitous in covering up sexual abuse, they will go to prison. Am I wrong, Elise?
Well, they should.
So hold on, hang on. That will go to prison.
That's a big statement that she made there. If you know that's actually happening,
you have an
step forward and
by the way, if you know something, you yourself have some information that would lead to evidence to that effect, and you do not report it, you are duplicitous, and you are part of the crime. So I suggest if there's somebody, one... the incident on some Planned Parenthood, on some outlying part of the country where that happened, I hope you will prosecute that person.
Well, there are at least 7 states, Alabama, Arizona, Colorado, Ohio, California, Connecticut, and Minnesota, where assaults were reported to Planned Parenthood, but those clinics didn't report the cases to police as required. Allison Howard joins me now. Allison, what an amazing time you had on Dr. Drew. Tell us more about what happened on his show.
Well, thank you so much for having me, and thank you for letting me share the truth of what Planned Parenthood is doing behind closed doors. I was invited on to talk about a certain hashtag, but the conversation quickly moved. As soon as I mentioned that Planned Parenthood fails to report sexual abuse, Dr. Drew and his crew rightfully got outraged. But I wish that they were outraged at Planned Parenthood instead of outraged at me for bringing it up.
Indeed.
There's tons of documentation showing their failure to report sexual abuse of minors, failure to report rape, and those are very important things we need to care about for the issue alone, and also that our taxpayer dollars are going to this organization.
And what more can you tell us about these unreported cases?
Well, if you look in the states that you listed, young girls have been taken by their perpetrators to Planned Parenthood. And Planned Parenthood, as a healthcare, those practitioners there, they're required by state law to report sexual abuse. And when a minor is pregnant, there is enough there to report a suspicion of sexual abuse. And so we wish Planned Parenthood was doing that, but they're not. They're failing to report it. And so this is, I wish what Dr. Drew said was happening. He said that we should be prosecuting these people, that this needs to be reported. And it's true. Our young girls are being hurt at Planned Parenthood. And we're calling on so many to highlight that, to continue to bring it up.
Well, what does the law say? And is it consistent in all 50 states?
Well, the law differs in different states to reporting. But what we do know is that just this week, the president of Planned Parenthood, Cecile Richards, sat down before Congress and testified for hours, rightfully so, about the practices of her organization. We deserve to know what's going on behind Planned Parenthood's doors because we give them $1.5 million of taxpayer funds every single day. That's over $500 million a year. They've failed to report sexual abuse. They're using taxpayer money in very suspicious ways. And really, some videos show that they're profiting off of the harvesting of baby body parts. And so many have called that we redirect those funds to federally qualified health centers that are better able to provide care for women without all the scandal of Planned Parenthood.
Well, Allison, why does the mainstream media have such a hard time believing anything negative about Planned Parenthood?
Yeah, well, it's a great question. I think that the fact that this story has continued to thrive without major networks covering it to the extent that they should shows that the American people care so much about Planned Parenthood's business practices. Also, the fact that just this week's hearing, the coverage of that hearing was very minimal, and then they cared more about the questioners and the line of questioning versus the person in the hot seat, Cecile Richards. She needs to be more transparent and open with the American people. And, you know, we now have her on record admitting that Planned Parenthood does not provide mammograms. Alliance Defending Freedom filed a FOIA and found that not one single Planned Parenthood has a license to do mammograms. We also saw halfway through the hearing yesterday, as reported to into the report, that there is now a forensic analysis done on these videos that shows that nothing is deceptive, and the only thing cut out is people eating, pre-meeting chatter, and bathroom breaks, which I'm very grateful that they edited that out. But it just goes to prove that if you have access to YouTube, you have access to see what's happening inside Planned Parenthood.
Absolutely amazing. So what will it take to see Planned Parenthood defunded and the image that most Americans have of it change?
Sure. Well, they're not providing comprehensive care like they claim. They're also making $127 million in profit every year. So if you're not doing mammograms and you can't use taxpayer funds for abortion, what are you doing with all of this money? And could that money be better used if it was redirected to other federally qualified health centers that do more care? They provide cardiovascular care, immunizations, pediatric eye, ear, and wellness visits. If you go to getyourcare.org, you can see the thousands of better options for women than Planned Parenthood. And at getyourcare.org, there's the website, the address, the contact info, and as a true resource to help women know that Planned Parenthood is not your only option.
Well, what about America's younger generation, Allison? Are they trending more pro-life? Can they change all of this?
Yeah, this is the most pro-life generation. You bring up a great point. We now, as millennials, see not only inside the womb in the sense of 4D ultrasounds, which are so neat, but we have the stories on our side. So science and stories are showing us what's happening and the truth behind true care for women in unplanned pregnancies. And it's the Christian community that's coming around these women and supporting them and saying, look, you can define success for yourself and you can do it by giving life to your child, and we're here to help. And so on getyourcare.org is a link to all of those pregnancy resource centers and ways to help if you're in an unplanned pregnancy. And so I would encourage anyone today to go and check that out.
We will certainly continue that conversation online as people log on. Allison Howard, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for having me.
And up next, we will pray about these pro-life issues and more headlines here on CBN News. Before we get to our prayer time, we want to tell you about a roundtable analysis of another big story in the headlines this week. Our headline, Russia goes to war in Syria, but against whom? We take a closer look at Russia's move into Syria. CBN's George Thomas, Gary Lane, and Chris Mitchell look at what it means for the Middle East and the world with perspective you can only find from CBN News. Well, along with praying about the pro-life issue in America, this week we also want to pray through the headlines and include the situation in Syria, praying for all of the refugees, and back here at home for the people in Oregon who lost loved ones to a gunman at a community college there, and for Israel as the Jewish state mourns the death of two young parents killed in a drive-by shooting, leaving four orphaned children. Let's pray. Father, we do lift up all of these issues in the headlines, Lord God, what's happening in the pro-life arena, Lord God. We're praying in the name of Jesus that you would intervene concerning Planned Parenthood's funding. We're praying for Syria and all of those who are refugees, Lord God, who are just lost. They have no homes. Father God, many of them are suffering, don't have food. We're praying for your help with that situation, Lord. We're praying for Israel, for peace in the Middle East, Lord God. We're praying for this family, Lord, these four children who lost their parents. They were gunned down in front of their children, and we're praying for your help. Comfort them, Lord. You are the God of all comfort. Father, we bring all of these needs to you. We're asking that you would bring peace to those who need peace. We're praying, Lord, for your will concerning this situation in Syria and Russia, Lord God, intervening. We're asking, Lord God, that you, Lord Jesus, would give wisdom, Father God, to those who are in leadership, Lord God. We're praying, Father, for your heart, for the lost. You said the harvest is white, but the laborers are few. And we're asking for your help, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Well, that is going to do it for the time that we have on CBN News Sunday. Remember, you can catch all of the news that matters to you 24/7 at cbnnews.com or follow us on Facebook and Twitter and even on Instagram. Until next time, may God bless you and keep you.